What's up, FCC? Welcome back to Inside the Circle. This time we're going to get insight on what happens on the weekends. As long as time permits, we get the crew together, we get some battles in. You're about to see Bucket, Bison, Akuma and Seth versus the Smithbad Haka. So, sit back and enjoy. This is Inside
the Circle. Hi, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Inside the Circle. We're going to go some first to five sets. Champ on board. That's how we like to do it. We have the Smithbad playing out a player two side. Versus Bucket playing Bison out of the first player side. They the second batch, second fight of the day. And Bucket seems to be pretty even so far. Bucket plays a good Bison. He has a nice pressure game. And he's trying his best to apply it right now against Denzel's Hakan. A good 9 hit. He seems to be warming up this Bison. Not dropping too many links so far. Oh, I can't call him there with the normal grab. Oh wow, nothing to follow up after that crumple. Very strange. Bucket came in and he missed. Takes this round convincingly. Saito crusher. Smithbad had the meter advantage. Of course, Hakan always better with starting oiled up. Smithbad decides to go with the Super Street Fighter version of Hakan. It's not working out too well all for now. But once he could get some oil on him, then he could get himself green. Nothing seems to be happening. This round is all Bucket this time. Working on that perfect. Seems to be hungry for that perfect. Well, it is, yes! Bucket records the first perfect of the day against the Smithbad with his experimental pick. I'm not sure if the Smithbad know that the Ultra version of Hakan will be stronger, seeing as he's going back to Super Street Fighter version where he does not start oiled up. Still heading for character select now, maybe he's about to change that. So you'll see what happens here. Bucket expressing some impressions with that Vega player, but doesn't really have the confidence. He's switching to the Ultra version of Hakan. He's going to be starting oil up now. Yeah, as long as it's Ultra or AE 2012, he's going to start oiled up. That was a demand most Hakan players had. You know, they added that he starts the round oil up, which is better normals and of course better range on some of his special moves. So he'll be able to get you much easier and be more effective in the fight. And as you notice, Bucket has switched the set. He's an okay set player, and the way we do it is all free for all open. You know, you could choose to pick different characters even if you win. And they may take advantage of that. So now let's see what's going to happen. That Hakan is all oiled up to start the round at least. He's going to have better normals, a better focus attack, and he'll be able to handle himself much better in the game. Yeah, Hakan does have some reach in the air as well. He also has a decent air grab. And that slide two could be quite effective if you could come out with special moves after that as well. And while they wouldn't link, they would definitely be effective. Sorry about that, folks. Had to respond to my aunt. Looks like Hakan was successful this time around. Taking the first round, closing it out to the Ultra. And Damien sneaking in a crouching fierce, or standing fierce, David Seth, to open the round. Seth is a very tricky, high momentum character, too. come at you and start some long combos from the air. A decent dive kick. Hakan is establishing his grappler game. Hasn't seen his speed bar do any oiling up during the round. Not sure if he has a good enough grip on this character just yet, but it's gonna be pretty decent. The Smith Bad is showing his propensity to, you know, keep buttons in with that low jab as he does with his other characters, but Hakan low jab is a bit slower than he used to. Well, we see how he employs his tactic with his characters too. That crouching jab usually keeps him safe. With his other characters, but I'm not sure how he's gonna use it with Hakan, and Bucket takes it. Second round. So this is round 3. Oh wow. Good jumping kick. Smith Bad lands some decent holds. Good mix up. Ooh, catches him with the reset. Bucket is trying to employ some decent pressure right now. Not really up to speed with Seth so far today. The fight's just started too. Else he'd be landing more of his links. Gets him with the hold there. This is gonna go Hakan's way for sure. There he lands with the ultra. It's not a full ultra, but it is quite effective, especially in the corners there. Anything in the air is gonna land in the stomach most likely. I don't know what Capcom was thinking when they programmed it, but some players really took advantage. Yeah, Bucket putting the pressure back on again. Oh wow, Bucket is starting to warm up. The Smith Bad isn't having it, and he's gonna chip him out with this ultra too. Oh, not enough. Hakan took it. The Smith Bad took that one. He thought he went for some tricky stuff for Hakan, but Bucket wasn't that successful this time around, and Hakan takes that round, that fight. So his score is now 1 each, basically. Although he took the first one, but I wouldn't count that first one. We hadn't started recording yet, so it's 1 each. They're sticking with these characters now. Hakan with that crazy reach while he's oiled up. Oh, I don't feel like this Smith Bad is really making most of the punishing opportunities here with Hakan, but he'll get it going. Oh god. Bucket needs to put down his feet here and let the Smith Bad know he's not just going to be taking those slides over and over, that spamming of that slide. But the Smith Bad is the type of guy who would repeat as long as it's working, he's going to keep on doing what he's doing. Tried to combo that, didn't quite get it. Smith Bad. Yeah, he has the super stocked. Seth's not too far, there he goes, he has the super stock. And he has an interesting way of using his super to kind of grind you out, Bucket, and oh god, goes again with the ultra. Bucket has a way he likes to use the super to grind you out, just to rub it in your face while he kills you with it. But he doesn't get the opportunity there. However, both players will be starting in the next round. All stocked up. Let's see which way to go now. Again, crazy reach with that oil. Gets different properties with his game. That oil, unfortunately, isn't projectile invincible unless it's the DX version. 2, 3, 4. Ooh, Bucket goes postal with that one. And then he drops some of his combos there, hit a little too high in the air, but he lands the grab. Oh no! Wow, hard luck. I'm not sure if that on all is projectile invincible, but hey, they tried. This round kind of caused some desperation right now. The rumor was once the only thing Bucket good for is the toad water, but it looks like he's putting up a good fight right now. Oh no, kind of sloppy play in the end by both players, but Bucket takes it. And here we go, round 3 of fight number 3. Oh. gets the full effects of that move. There he goes again with that two hit. Oh, there he goes. He likes to do this with the super, but sigh of disappointment. You know, that really wasn't his objective. Or he would have gotten more damage out of it. Has decent damage output. And there we go. Bucket's warming up to his combos. I don't feel like... Oh, there he goes. Postal again. Good setup. But he gets him with the throw. And I don't feel like Bucket really comfortable just yet with his set, or he'll be executed much better. But all for now, this is what takes place. Oh, and Bucket is feeling Hakan's strength with his aerial attacks. Much to his disappointment, the Smith Bat takes two in a row with his experiment of a character that he's picked up here. I really don't know what is going through the mind of the Smith Bat. Bucket retreats the character select and see which way it goes. While I'm checking out my fighter, Beta Fish. Decent little fella. This rivalry does go back some time to after Old Edition days. Rivalry go all the way back to Old Edition days on Super Nintendo. So these bouts have serious meaning for these players. I remember they used to be forced to walk the Green Mile and purchase tokens at the local arcade in Labre. Those were the good old days. So Bucket decides to switch to Akuma. As the Smith Bat remains with his experiment of Hakan. And here we go again. Secret laboratory, and the Akuma seems to be faring much better than Seth was. With his multiple aerial attacks that Akuma has, he'll be able to build some decent meter, but oh, he can't make mistakes like that. Smith Bat will definitely punish. And there he goes again, spamming the slide. As long as it works, he's going to use it. As for anything, you know, if it's not wrong, go try to fix it. There he goes, decent punish by Akuma, by Bucket. And he stays away, gets his projectile game going, zoning Hakan out as he should zone any grapple out, and he takes it away. Crouching forward into fireball, takes that round. A bold uppercut to start the round. Wasn't sure if he was expecting him to come from the air so early. Smith Bat definitely not that kind of guy. Setting up a decent offense with Akuma. Should have anti-aired there. It led to that hole. And here he goes. Bucket has decent combos with Akuma, as he's showcasing right now. Going for some decent damage, not too much styling. And he's trapping him in the corner here. Which could be a dangerous place for Akuma, although Hakan is the one who's in the corner. But oh, he takes it. Hakan has some decent reversals. If he could just get his hands on him, it'll be all over. But he's out. Continues. Oh, FADC the jab. Don't know why he did that. He's not too good at controlling the space bucket as the Smith Bat starts to get a good read on him. Oh, what in the world happened there? He got caught with a jab? I thought I was supposed to deal with aerial attacks. I don't understand that one. Combo Fiend, you have some explaining to do. Yeah, I would have tried to poke too. I didn't know that would hit like that. Okay, more reason to go into the lab. Decent punish. Okay, Bucket really putting the pressure on. Very unhappy with how he lost that round, I suspect. And he's making the Smith Bat pay. Oh, decent safe jump setup. Smith Bad Weather then grabbed him instead. Smith Bad is doing a pretty good job dealing with the projectiles, but not making decent use of his meters, and you know, to get a punish after he gets around the fireball. Although these meters could help him to get around the fireball as well. And he loses that one, so the 2-1 streak is all over. Yeah, I knew that Ultra 2 from Hakan really works really well as an anti-air move, but first time I ever saw it work in that way. Yeah, that's right, he did. Paid the price. What a costly one it was. So Akuma took that fight, and here he is setting up his offense again. His bucket. Oh no, we can't throw out these kind of reckless uppercuts like that. Reckless dragon punch. Smith Bad, he's going to be able to deal with it easy. Oh, good catch with the two hits after the air to air. Oh, there, the pressure. Caught him there this time from behind. Let's see, is he gonna mix him up? No. He stays square, keeps it fair this time. No dirty vortex. But he's gonna make the most of that. And he caught him there, this is gonna take the round. Bucket doesn't employ much vortex. Yeah, I feel like if you use the EX spin, it might kill it. It is quite effective. It's a very unique ultra, and it works with great effect. Oh wow! No. Okay, well guys, try not to make too many reckless mistakes. And that's what I'm talking about with, you know, not getting to fully punish with Hakan. I think maybe if this Smith Bad had more time with this character to learn, he'd be able to punish quite effectively, and he would be finishing rounds a lot faster. And here we are in the corner again. A little too early. Just looking forward to him jumping towards to keep him in the corner and keep the pressure going, but waste of an ultra right there. Oh, and Smith Bad is trying to Bucket is trying to finish it. He's about to with this projectile game. Nice and good. How come, Otto?
Oh, heaven and earth tremble before my might. This is the last round. Fight!
Oh, wow. Smith Bad confused as to which ultra is his. Oh, no, he misses. How did that miss? Yeah, that's another super move too with funny properties. I think you can hold that. I'm not sure. And there he is, Smith Bad with his signature buttons, keeping that jab going as a protective move. Close range. Yep, that crouching forward is a good punish for that move once he blocks it. Smith Bad has to know when to FADC and make the most. Bucket keeping his projectile game up. Trying to zone him out. Ooh, good grab. That does have priority over that. And Bucket takes it with this one. FADC was going for that. Yeah, so even Bucket is impressed with it. Even Bucket is impressed with the Hakan play so far. The score is now 3-2. Bucket. Yeah, he has a nice low jump, which could really screw up your timing if you're custom fighting against characters who has a long high jump, and then he has some strong normals in the air as well. Here we go, Hakan is get his momentum up. But still not able to touch Akuma so far. Akuma keeping a good zoning game. Keeping him at bay. And, ooh, there he goes to close the gap. And this is where Hakan could get dangerous. He's close. Ultra is stock time already. Oh, dropping combos again is Bucket. Keeping the pressure up. Not much changing. Yeah, not much to talk about in this round. Very good. Convincing round, decent zone out game with projectiles. And Bucket forced to take this, has the meter advantage as well, but there's that oil with Hakan starting the round. Ooh, good decent 3-hit combo. He was trying to land at a while now. And Smithbad really hungry to get at him with ooh, this one should. No, it doesn't! Wow! He stops it with the crouching forward. Smithbad is hungry to get the wins with this guy, which is not really his thing. He doesn't really play much of a rush down game. But yeah, he goes with this one. And he's whiffing some normals. Not sure why. Keeping up the projectile game, which is. Yeah, I find it strange. This is strange that this projectile game is actually working against this Smithbad. Good FADC, just keep it safe. Buffet there again, dropping combos. You'd normally go for more hits there. Yeah, he closes that one out. The fight so far aren't looking so. They're not looking so aggressive and convincing. But both players need to warm up. Score is now 4-2. So Bucket is on match point.
It's the battle of the century.
So here we go. Bucket about to close this one out against this experimental Hakan gameplay by Smithbad. And let's see what's gonna happen here now. Here he goes again with his zoning game, just building meter with those moves and building meter with those projectiles. Of course, happy to land them whenever he could. Good. Is that standing fierce? I have this is where Bucket is putting the pressure on. In the corner now though. Oh, should be able to get. No, chooses not to get out. Smithbad is about to take advantage of that, I'm sure. And he has to watch that ultra too. Bucket is one too, can get very aggressive. And right here, oh, there we go. As I call it, you could definitely actually want to rush. You know, Bucket is one that talks about, you know, holding your ground once you have your lead. Now the Smith playing a very uncharacteristic game too. He's rushing in when he has the lead. This is not like him, but he seems to really be enjoying this player hack, this character Hakan, and enjoying rushing. I feel he really had some problems in the lab past week working on Hakan, but see what's gonna happen here. Good air to air. Oh, misses his combo. Wow. What is going on? Yeah, it's just a slow. What happened to all the rush down that was taking place in the last round? Risky DP here, please. And there we go again with the aggressive play by Hakan. He's keeping away from the fireballs quite decently. Getting close to Akuma now, being effective. Could close it out. Oh. Alright, this could be. Oh no, it's not. And Smithbad is definitely going to save those meters for the next round. So as should both players do. Because Bucket still has the, you know, the games in hand. Is he going to? Yes, he does. Oh god. Really put in a statement on his game there right now. Smithbad is wise stage here. Look out for the net for the super as well. And Bucket takes it. Bucket takes it at 5-2. Bucket wins that round. Which is not bad. Not quite up to speed as Bucket just yet, but like I said, the afternoon is young, fights just started. So I'm about to take the control now. I don't very much get any commentary from the Smith Bad, but if you're blessed enough, you just might.
Well, that's it. You just saw the Smith Bad lose to Bucket in his first of five set. So let me give a shout out to Mr. Spectacular One and Jerry Alfred. Big up. We'll be putting these videos out every Saturday from now on, so you can stick around and look forward to that. For more information on us, of course, follow us on Facebook and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. You've been Inside the Circle.